scene. They make it work.
Exactly. Really waiting until the last few seconds here. And they decide to go with a solo lane Lee Sin, from the looks of it. That'll be Westrice on Lee Sin. I think they're... because they need to be able to pick something that can lane against Lulu top or something else. They want to be able to wait for their mid lane pick to be a counter pick, most likely. So that means they may as well just pick the top laner blind. And right. They have to be able to do that into Lulu.
Also denying the shot caller a few more junglers with the ban of Kha'Zix as well. So hopefully they can kind of get under No Name's skin, force him onto something. But I don't know if you can force No Name onto something. He plays quite a bit. Twitch grabbed up for Vasili, allows him to turn on the aggression if he wants. They get that thresh away from Bubba Dub, which is really great because Bubba Dub definitely has been making plays for Complexity when the time comes.
Absolutely. Bubba Dub has played a great game yesterday. Leaving the Twitch through is a little bit risky for Complexity.
Yeah.
With no Lucian to try and match his aggression in the lane, Complexity is definitely just going to have to go with Corki here. Because that's kind of the third tier AD carry, something Robert X Lee has a lot of experience on as well. But that's probably going to be a lane swap situation now.
A lot of power coming from this team so far. Damage everywhere for Complexity. So fights could either go fast or slow because it's also quite squishy. Wow.
Oh, Vasili.
Pain love. Elise is still there. She got through. And possibly the LeBlanc last pick blue side here for LMQ.
Yeah.
Hey. You're going by the wayside here when you try to ban out what you think is going to be the scariest.
Xiao Xiao's LeBlanc has been pretty potent, but we've seen some pretty strong Nidalee play. And honestly, Nidalee against a Zyra support is good. She is very squishy, and if she tries to walk up to set up a play, Spirit of the Face usually calms that down a little bit.
Definitely give him a good comp. Help to counteract Robert X Lee's poke if they lock this in. Everybody likes a heal plus wild growth as well, so you're going to have a great team fight.
So much protection for Twitch. It is almost like a Protect the Twitch, but with a lot of kiting power throughout the team. It's a very squishy team composition for LMQ, but with enough shields to keep the squishy people alive.
Right, well, they're going up against Squish right now, so unless we get some sort of tank coming out in the mid lane here for Brawly, I think it might be Squish Fest all around the map. He's definitely considering here. Got one hotshot leg up. Get the thought on.
Does he try to go for Twisted Fate? Something that COG nearly executed just in our first game against Cloud9. Brawly is kind of known to play anything.
I think he's thinking, I'd love to play Ziggs right now.
He always wants to play Ziggs. He'd be able to shove out Nidalee.
Yeah.
Come on, guys. Just Ziggs. Why don't I just play Ziggs?
A great steal, though, as well, onto that Lulu now that Brawly is kind of left thinking. Could have played a Lulu. He's going to rock the Orianna. Has a bit of ball delivery with Westrice if he can get himself into these fights, but good safety on their side since they didn't have a tank to get a shield.
Yeah, it's worth noting that in the promotion tournament that Complexity qualified with, Brawly did exceptional in lane against Shifter, especially CS-wise, when they knock Coast out of the LCS. So it's definitely a champion. He has a lot of laning power on.
Yeah.
And every time you see like mid lane nerfs or something, Orianna is always there and ever present. It's something that the best mid laners really know how to play. And he needs the laning power against a guy as good as Xiao Xiao. So I do like that pick, even if it's not Ziggs.
Right. Still going to be playing well. Orianna versus Nidalee isn't really fun for Nidalee before the first, but she just stands under a turret and throws spears anyways. Cue high. The teams have chosen their champs, and according to LOLESports.com, you have chosen LMQ to win. 87% of the vote, quite up there.
Yeah, but remember, if you feel the momentum shifting at any point during the game, update a vote by sending a Twitter message to the @LOLESports account with the hashtag LMQWin or COLWin.
It's funny how fast that changes, too. Somebody gets a triple kill, somebody gets a kill on the top side of the map, and you're like, oh, let me go ahead and just revote. Yeah.
It's the information superhighway.
It is.
Things go quickly. You can tweet whenever you want.
Well, we'll see how many tweets we get this game. If Complexity can actually turn the tide against LMQ, we said they're coming off a big momentous game for them. They are seeing wins with Kez so far, and that may give them what they need. Kez kind of has a voice now. We know Brawly is the shot caller, and the team is happy to have him back, so they could get that boost of power that they need here.
And vision is the thing we have to be tracking this
That's
game.
That's right.
Because I was blown away when we pulled that stat. For instance, 49 wards placed. Obviously, you place more wards when you're playing Sightstone, Lee Sin. That is a given. But Broken Shard plays Lee Sin occasionally too. In Broken Shard's two Lee Sin games, he placed an average of 13 wards.
Right.
There were 49 wards placed
by
Kez in a single game. That's actually more wards than Broken Shard placed in Super Week combined.
Yeah. We're going to have to see if they keep that vision up. It's been something Dignitas used to shoot to the top of the record. Even Cloud9 stated it. High was covered right below him, and Dig kept warding the same spot. Once you have vision of that area, you almost control that entire side of the map. We'll see if either of these teams employ that here. Slow movement as everybody makes it out. Sweeper in the hands of No Name this time. And actually, it's a little bit of a different start. Kind of the same as Lemonation as well, but more
fresh,
decides.
Very frequently starting with the health crystal because Sidestone immediately is a good call for him. He doesn't have the easy execute on the Targon's Brace, so that doesn't work too well. This is so interesting. Basically, teams are going to pick up on this eventually. LMQ has done this exact same blue side opening three games in a row, and when they're on the red side, they did the exact same thing to Complexity. Teams are going to start waiting in that brush that LMQ walks through and just kill them. Complexity could have done that in this game if they just grasping rooted that spot exactly there. Maybe now that I've said it, it's not going to happen again, but LMQ is incredibly predictable level one, and it will eventually be punished unless they change up.
Well, the ward's placed. Everybody's going to be hatching them right now, but look at LMQ as they've back. They only saw Nidalee come back. They think they are still in the jungle. Kez,
this is so bad.
First one to alert.
This is so bad by Complexity because this is the opening that LMQ has used previously. They go in, they leave one ward back in their own jungle so they know if they get counter-invaded, and Complexity is going to get caught out by this ward. All that has to happen is the hook just has to land, and they started it even.
3, 2, and 1. Oh, he misses the hook just on the outside. Clearly planned and clearly thwarted there. Complexity dodges quickly, gets themselves to safety here, and LMQ is going to be forced to kind of recuperate. But we're going to get matched up lanes. I lag it.
Yep, we still get the standard lanes because of the delayed invade. Ooh. Stuff, and this actually benefits LMQ as well, these lane matchups. They want the Twitch Thresh against the Zyra Corki. One Death Sentence landing, and they get a big edge with the teleport, and with the way the lanes are laid out, the junglers are most likely still going to be able to pick up double buffs apiece. Kez is just going to be slightly behind, and he also is going to be a little bit low on health.
That's what hurts. All that work probably was doing one spear back to him. He cancels all those auto attacks and the ball movement, but he still keeps Xia Wei Xiao in a good spot. Great farming by Xia Wei Xiao as well to get the spears behind Prowly. It's going to be fun lane, like I said, for Xia Wei Xiao here in the early game. But he has heal. He'll be okay now.
Yeah, we'll have to see his CS tracking. He hadn't lost a CS at 10 battle against anyone going into this week. And he actually did lose CS at 10 yesterday to Bjergsen by a small margin.
Ever so small. Kez didn't have huge early impact coming out on Lee Sin yesterday, so we'll see how he works the Evelynn play today. It was a little slow, had definitely a few bushwhacks that didn't work, just kind of sitting in the brush wasting time. But like you said, the calls coming out very big. And not having to play with the buddy system this time, we'll see how much that gives him some power.
Yeah, finally a standard game here where the junglers really get to work. Will they have practice doing this? Because all the LCS games have been the 2v0s.
It's so foreign now.
Yeah, Kez needs to be able to get some deep wards, but he's just trying to farm for the first four levels. So really, it's all about snowballing Ackerman's lane if Westrice wanders too far from home. But this doesn't look like the best of ganks unless Westrice decides to go a little bit aggressive.
Cocoons are oh so close, but there's always just a few minions in the way for him to knock it down. No Name still saving it. Beautiful grab just to the left of the minions. Bubbadub tries to actually return a bit of fire.
Westrice, he's went a little far up. One Glitter Lance.
As the Glitter Lance hit, the cocoon comes from the other side. He had no idea. What a well-planned executed kill and gank coming in from LMQ.
It was a nice timing for No Name to be up there, but honestly, Westrice misplayed that one. He doesn't have a way of pushing the wave against Lulu. He kind of needs to turtle at his turret for the first little while. You can see even when he was up there, he was out of minions by the time he got cocooned, so he should have just been back at his turret to play safe. Still, means one kill for No Name, and let's see how he transitions that one.
See if he can come down to help Xia Wei Xiao at all. Probably doing a great job leveling W on this one, trying to burst down the heal that Xia Wei Xiao would be giving himself. He has to watch out if he does use that dissonance. He doesn't have the speed to get out of this. Looks like he'll be safe. was going to say Kez was going to come down, but there's no counter gank that's going to happen here. Xia Wei Xiao back to just simple farming. 34 to 23 so far. Very good favorite Prawly here.
Yeah, Prawly's been doing a lot of nice ball movement while the minions are on Xia Wei Xiao's turret. So every time he wants to get the last hit in, when he knows he's going to stop to attack, he'll throw the ball out and get the dissonance on. Or if he wants to dodge it, Xia Wei Xiao misses that CS. Mm-hmm. Still a good amount of CS picked up with the turret there.
It's very hard to keep hitting CS under the turret, especially this low in the game as a Nidalee, so absolutely great play. 25 to 23 in the top lane, so Westrice wasn't actually able to teleport up, but was already had a bit of a lead there. So now as Ackerman returns, they try to return the favor. Yeah,
with the big mini wave, it's a question of how aggressive is Ackerman going to get. They're trying something.
There's one. Cripple goes down. I don't know if they're going to have enough speed on this one. He already connected with the resonating strike, so they don't have the gap closer. Good safe play by Ackerman. Teleports is up for him.
Flash.
Could be the hook. Oh, whoa, the flash coming in for one. They get the hook to the backside. Here's the teleport up for Ackerman. He just walked back to lane and looks like, oh man.
Oh no.
They're gonna stop that one down actually. He does not come, no, he does come in. It's just a little bit later. Westrice was the one coming in first. He's gonna be going down. Robert X Lee gets turned on now and Ackerman says, don't worry, I'll push him off for the extra pressure.
Things are really not going Westrice's way right now, because as he went to safeguard to the minion for the last auto attack, Twitch went fully invisible and he couldn't get that attack off. I believe that's what happened anyway. They knew there was no flash on a Bubba Dub, although the plant did make No Name flash forward into the stun. Obviously, Robert X Lee has to commit everything to get the kill on Moore. Oh, fight mid.
Oh, right in there. The swipe, the pounce. They do get Prawly. Got himself a lead in mid, felt a little too sure.
Yeah, and honestly, that was because of the play that Westrice had previously made. He was at a top lane, which left no pressure for Ackerman. Ackerman teleported in to help with that kill onto Prawly. So the whole team working together for these LMQ advantages.
Ackerman all over the place. Kayla yesterday, Lulu today, just really spicing it up for the team. Let's take one more look at this gank. Coming up from bottom.
I think he teleported in.
He teleported in the bottom fight, and he just came up.
Yeah, and he just walked up to that one. So probably
coast to coast. Little lackage of wards. They have good wards deep, but when they're already on your side of the jungle, you need to be protected on that side too. Westrice, not enough energy here. It's all about auto attacks. Could get the last Sonic Wave in just on the edge each time. This is good for him against that Ackerman lane, but he's going to be catching up on kills now. The CS will be in his favor.
Yeah.
Have to watch out.
Going to try and become a split push threat on that Lee Sin, but the start has not been promising. The lanes, CS-wise, had been going quite well for Complexity. It's not like they're bad players by any stretch, but things have really just not been going their way. Small little mistakes cascading into larger advantages for LMQ. Kez finds a friend.
Oh, does not look like they're going to let this one go easy. No Name gets out. He does not have Ignite or anything ticking on him. Good to go for there. Back to the blue buff. We'll see who's able to get out of this. Smite's down on the side of No Name at this point.
How many spears can land? It might be a smite roar.
Oof, little flay back. There we go. So good to go over to Kez. Not a problem there. Probably doesn't exactly need it in mid. We'll see how LMQ continues to react. Always trying to put the pressure on to Complexity right now. So far, they're doing a damn good job.
Bubba Dub is so squishy, though, on Zyra. One death sentence. You can see one death sentence forced his flash, and then at that point, he's just a sitting duck. His flash is back up right now, but he doesn't have the health to really sustain anything. Nice little buff steal, though.
Smart play. It'll definitely help. It's not going to give Xia Wei Xiao any more control without that blue buff, so he is kind of fending for himself now, going over to see if it's there.
Throughout all of this, the gold lead is actually staying rather small. It's only 600 for Complexity being down, so they're still keeping their CS up fairly healthily. That has to do with the Orianna obviously being better than Nidalee, but now is the point of the game where LMQ might look to control Dragon a little bit, especially when Ackerman's teleport comes back up.
Slow moving here, Bubba Dub. Robert actually trying to pressure the turret a little bit. As he said, with that Dragon in preparation, a lot of wards from Complexity have now been placed in the river after Prawly went down in the top lane. Kez gets the red buff on. It's going to be the Wild Growth. Whimsy's there. It's only got a few more seconds. One return. Glitter Lance. He should be all right. Forces a flash. That forces his. Oh, the shield goes on. He is going to live through that situation. It's going to be the spears now from Xia Wei Xiao. As soon as LMQ sees a fight, they start to converge on it instantly. This is going to be the turnaround, and he gets the double buffs.
Nothing Westrice is doing this game is going well. He is so close to so many kills, but he just can't convert. And after a certain amount of time, it's just going to get out of control.
Yeah.
That was such a close fight, but it was just a bait by Ackerman. They wanted the counter gank. It was a little slow, and then the Lee Syndrome really hurt him at that one. No eyes on Lee.
Oh, Xiaowei Xiao going in hard. Four levels in his spear. Two levels, in the heal to make sure he can deny that dissonance damage, and it works out well.
Most importantly, the double buffs as well to make sure there's absolutely no escape. This one, let's take another look at this fight in the top lane. It was a great start by Complexity, kicking him into the queue. Ackerman actually detonated it so the first Resonating Strike didn't connect, which kind of gave him time to jump over the wall in that first point. Kez was already on the way out. No Name stun was timed just right. Ackerman, like you said, 15 health or so. All the while, the collapse was coming. There has to be a timer in Complexity's heads. How long until this fight becomes a bad idea? The MIA was most likely called by Prawley by the end of it, and it just turned into disaster.
Cascading as well into a middle lane turret. Have to see what these teams have for each other coming up in the first dragon fight. It looks like it's actually being pressured right now by LMQ, and I don't think Complexity is going to be able to do much. They are answering, losing a mid turret, and they're trying to hold their lanes. Right now on the top, Westrice should be able to get this, but I don't know. It looks like it's going to be Xiaowei Xiao on his tail here.
Yeah, well, the turret goes down. Xiaowei Xiao is going to move up there for the minions, and they're going to sustain the
club. Really?
Ackerman. Maybe he's going to go for a kill. Westrice might have to burn his kick here. Well, he did, but that didn't get rid of the problem.
Got to be careful if you walk next to a wall with skill shots. You kind of pinch yourself in and slice the pie for the other person. It's not going to be necessary. Xiaowei Xiao takes it out, and he gets a solo lane farm to himself.
Very painful day for Westrice. It is making this game get a little bit out of control. Xiaowei Xiao 4-0-1 now because of all the kills he's been able to pick up. A lot of them just in the top lane onto Westrice. Finishing his Athenes, he's been going top to bottom, picking off Prawley and Westrice. The bottom lane for Complexity has been performing quite well, CS-wise, but the rest of the map is just getting out of hand.
And we can see, now that we get the standard lanes, plethora of roaming from both teams. We've had Ackerman in the bottom lane, Xiaowei Xiao going everywhere. Without the buddy system in the jungle, it frees up that movement for the mid laners now.
Yeah, the mid laners are roaming again. They're not trapped in the mid lane in a sense because with the 2-0, like you're saying, there's kind of three roamers, not including the mid laner. And Xiaowei Xiao is far enough ahead now, especially in experience, that he's just jumping into people. It's not even about the spear. They're trying to catch on to him.
Should be all right here. Going to be able to get away from the man shockwave. This is the thing. Like you were saying, Xiaowei Xiao's been all over the map, not killing Prawley. He's been getting his kills everywhere else, and Prawley can't fight him for that anymore. It becomes a very tough situation. And 12 minutes into, almost 13 minutes in now, that Athenes is finished on Xiaowei Xiao's, and it's still pieced together by Prawley.
And this is when the rest of the map collapses down to the only remaining strong point of Complexity. Everyone is trying to flank around here. It's a matter of how quickly can they run and what were they actually going to burn here. Xiaowei Xiao from the back.
You think that's the end of the line of LMQ champions, but they just keep entering into the fray. Few more shots, bump it up, and Robert X Lee down to just about half HP as they...
Oh my word!
Almost going down. Pretty much gritting his teeth to stay alive on that one. And Bubba Dub chugging a potion, still wants to stay and provide control for the fight. This is getting very dangerous.
They really want this blue buff. They do have a teleport for Ackerman if Complexity were to fully commit to this one. But LMQ is also very low, and they do not want to get caught in a shockwave.
I can't believe how much LMQ pushes their advantages here. They just keep wanting more, and it works.
Yeah, Robert X Lee trying to stand this turret. This is a trade from Vasily.
Ruh-roh, Vasily, you don't have more on the other side anymore. He goes in, it's gonna be the heal. One last shot. No, the dead venom's not. Yes, it does. Are you serious?
He's
I thought
alive.
He had at least 50 HP. Summoner heal by himself, the 1v1 and flash out. That was an 80 carry duo, if I've seen one.
And it just keeps getting worse. Even though Complexity has some decent vision coverage, there was a pink ward behind them. They keep getting
trapped inside
of their turret. They are so far behind here. It's just a matter of how many spears can you dodge.
It's like they've sectioned themselves off to only this portion
they
of the map
trapped.
To fight in.
Oh!
No way!
It's the ward around the corner. At this point, LMQ just has wards everywhere they need them.
They know they're kind of just getting outplayed right now. This is a rough game for Complexity. 10-1. We already have that 4,000 gold lead. Ackerman should be able to glitter lance this one down if he can apply E after his shield comes back off a cooldown. He uses it to deny the kick. Oh, he has to get the resonating strike. And Westrice, after all that trouble, gets to feel good about that one.
Yeah, absolutely. Westerice picks up a nice kill, but the rest of the map is against him at this point.
Yeah.
All the advantages he had given to Nidalee and Elise were just hammered home on the bottom end of Complexity. It's a nice redeeming kill there onto Ackerman, but it doesn't help their overall issues in this match.
Not at all. LMQ is just playing like a dream right now. Yeah. Fantasy team's quite happy.
I do want to talk about Vasily's play in the bottom lane there as well, because it's always this question about his... He's such an over-aggressive player in solo queue.
Is he going to get into
he
trouble?
He goes in, and is he going to get himself into trouble in the LCS? He hasn't been making the crazy moves as of yet, until now.
Until
but
now.
It was the
oh,
right
man.
Kind of crazy.
What do you mean crazy moves, Jack? I don't know what you mean. Oh, like this? But that's going to have to be thwarted.
He's
that
respecting
bit.
The Orianna ult right
He's
there.
Like, how much damage do I do? Oh, wait. He'll stay safe for the time being. That red buff, though, would easily give him the movement he needs to really outplay Prowly on this one. He's got
they
to watch
want to
out.
Dive.
Boar's coming around the backside. He just face plants into Kez and says, I'm all right with this because I also have Xiaowei Zhao. Somehow, they are always in a party of three because three's a crowd. This shockwave just missing. That means they are all over Prowly. He'll secure it onto that one. No Name taking out Bubbadub on the backside, pulls out the Stranglethorn on his own, and No Name not going to be able to get out of this. Kez wants everything, flashes into the wall with the sun in his eyes, and Westrice is going to go down as well. A double kill coming in for Ackerman, who was just in the top lane, but he teleported down. Why not?
It's a 5v5 in the bottom lane right now, and they are just trading blows.
I thought I called Bubbadub went down. He's still alive. Wait a minute. There we go.
Ace. Wow, LMQ is just hammering it home against Complexity right now, again and again and again in the bottom lane with no repercussions. 6-0-3 on a Xiaowei Zhao, but more so than the KDA, it's about the pressure he is creating on the map. He is cutting people off with his spears. Everything is going their way, even if they're taking a few casualties along the way. A great bait there by Vasily, not opening up when he threw the Venom Cast, which is what Prowly was predicting him to do, which is why the Shockwave missed. And then LMQ was just one step ahead of the game. They had five people down there before Complexity did. Robert X. Lee was on his way. Vasily was in the middle of everything opening up because none of the dive was concentrated onto him, and it just allowed the LMQ team to clean up across the board. Ackerman basically suicides himself to get enough damage onto Robert X. Lee, knowing the team had the chase to finish everyone else off.
LMQ in standard laning form throughout the game is just huge. The high caliber play coming out of this game doesn't seem like it could be stopped by anything we've seen lately. So far, they're able to go ahead and take Dragon for themselves here. We'll see what else they decide to pressure. This is pretty much LMQ with the pedal to the metal. And I think Robert X. Lee said it in the bumper video, if you give them an inch, they will take a mile.
Yeah, this game is actually very reminiscent of the types of games they had in the Challenger series, where they would just seemingly do whatever they want and just pick up kills across the map. They're 15 kills at 18 minutes right now because all of their moves are working, and LMQ is a team that just keeps going for it again and again.
That gold lead is really being stacked onto single champions as well. Xiaowei Zhao, 6-0-3. There's
Max
a
range.
Grab onto Kez. Max range indeed. Does what he can. A great shockwave coming out. Could be turned around for a kill, but they can't tunnel. Robert X. Lee puts himself right in the middle of the fight with a chance of Valkyrie over. So he does have his escape. He's thinking about that on the whole situation. Good play and safety from Prowly as well. They get a few kills, threading the needle on that one, but they have to be careful. You can see just going for a kill, they have to run away with their tail between their legs because there is a chance they'd go down instantly.
Wow. The fear every time you just start thinking about fighting them is huge. Complexity is trying to keep the map pressure up. Westrice is doing his damnedest to keep this side lane pressured as LMQ is making all these big plays across the map. And also, Ackerman hasn't built a single armor item, so his actual dueling power against Westrice isn't that great, since Lee Sin is really a great duelist in these split lanes.
Like, he's just been able to quickly buy that ability power. It's something we kind of saw, I believe, in the early portions of LMQ's play in the Challenger series. Not early portion, the later. But once they're ahead, they're going to start buying damage in every role, every class, without the necessary need for mitigating the damage on their side, because they're going to go through the fight so quickly. That's what we're seeing right now.
Yep.
They
Death
are not
cap
afraid.
Completed onto Xiaowei Zhao as well.
Yeah.
With the blue elixir to go with it.
Wow.
Well, why not? It's all about understanding the spikes in power right now. And when he finishes his death cap, his spears to start taking about half of people's health, since no one can build magic resistance. With the blue elixir, especially once he gets the blue buff, it's going to be taking him to 40% cooldown reduction as well as a huge spike in ability power. He's at 340 before consuming the blue elixir, and it's going to be spears for days with every one of them having threat to kill.
Looks like they're pressuring for that in just a few. Ward goes down. Oh, I thought Moore was going to be going for a grab here. Might actually get it. Good sidestep by Bubba Dub, but they're split right now. Shots can be hit on the turret. Robert X Lee is taking hits as well. Another 1v1 in the top lane, both level 12, but that's that damage from Ackerman. It's all he needs. Not enough time for the AD to come out.
Yeah, and enough AP along with the Morell and Omicron to cut Westrice's lifesteal in half. That's the spear we're talking about. On top of a trap, one shot kill.
You said it'd be half health, Jack.
To be fair, the trap did do a little bit of work, but that's exactly what he wanted.
Oh, he gets it! Flashes in range for the Blade of the Rune King. Face to face, they go Dukes up, and it looks like it's going to be Vasili taking that one out. Looks like he has hit the aggressive switch this game.
Good lord.
This is LMQ in full control.
Turret going down. Easy, easy for LMQ in the mid lane. We'll see if Brawly and team can stop it, though, in the base. Kind of get a little bit of help from the walls surrounding you. But right now, we've seen LMQ kind of consider those walls to not be there in their current gameplay.
And we saw LMQ in week one with the 4-0 start. They looked a little bit unstoppable. Did have that one close game against CLG. Week two, they looked a little bit more vulnerable, going 0-2. Yeah. But they came in this week with a little bit of a different play style in game one, solo lane-wise. And now, they seem to be back to their old Challenger Series domination, where they are just going absolutely anywhere they want, and there's nothing Complexity can do to stop it.
So many bits of poke, and if it's not poke, it's a cask that's going to slow you and not allow you to do anything anyways. So many things for Complexity to be thinking about as they match into this game against LMQ. One more time,
yeah,
that spear.
It was the trap with all the ability power he's had as well.
Tick, tick.
This means it ticks him down. The spear itself was max range, and it's low-level Nomadic resistance against a 390 ability power Nidalee. And then they decided to dive in the mid lane as well.
Oh, wow.
The post
oh, wow.
Goon Lance.
It's just one after the other that you see, and really great. If you don't have the Morgana, that's fine. Use the Thresh and the Elise coming in. Seems to be working out for LMQ here. They're playing it perfectly. 20-6, 22 minutes in with an 8,000 gold lead. LMQ definitely showing that they do prepare for each team. Many teams, when we ask them, you know, what are you guys going to do for tomorrow? They say, you know, we'll prepare. We'll look at some teams. LMQ says we have something prepared for each team, and it seems apparent.
Well, they have a bit more history against Complexity as well.
Right.
Thanks to the Challenger Series experience. Red team's turret has been destroyed. Knowing when and where to attack. Vasili, a little bit hasty on that initiation, I'd have to say. Too fast for the camera to see the open up, and he ends up falling before we get back to it.
Oh, Westrice. He's going to try to make a play here. The team is converging on. But you can just see the hook going out means LMQ already thought they had the upper hand in that fight, so you're coming into their area. The Wild Goat goes on. It looks like Complexity has actually turned it back into their home turf.
No AD
going
carry.
On to No Name now. Pulls him right into the box. Everybody else sees it, and they don't want to go and traverse that area just yet. Still on to Ackerman. Great shots going down, but the assists go to both sides with the kill as well. Westrice down deep into the fight. Doesn't have enough shield coming in for Brawly, and it is going to be him going down, but it's a double kill for Xiao Wei Xiao. Another great spear, Brawly ticking down, and he is going to be killed. Triple kill now for Xiao Wei Xiao on Nidalee in these fights. 10-0-4, and it's still going to be Xiao Wei Xiao toying right now. They missed the Grasping Roots. Still going to be going in. He's got blue buff and enough mana to keep going.
Wow, this game got a little bit messy. I feel like LMQ...
I think he's going to get another kill.
...is playing with their food a little bit right now. They're trying to be over-aggressive in here. Oh, no!
So close. He almost got another kill.
Just about.
Wow.
Another AP rune in there somewhere, and he would have had it.
That Void Staff being finished is really putting the pain on. World-class pain coming from Xiao Wei Xiao's spear right now, and... From high to Xiao Wei Xiao, the spears have been fantastic today.
The hit rate has definitely gone up a little bit.
Just a tad.
From these
spears. There's another one.
We hadn't been seeing much Nidalee, but she's reminding us that she still exists.
Everybody goes, remember? Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Now I do.
We'll see if Robert actually can return a bit of that poke. Not too much coming from him. He knows he can't really go farther out of the base. 23-10, so Complexity is picking up a few kills in these fights, but it's nothing to put that gold towards even what LMQ has surmounted right now on that lead.
Blue buff refresh for Shaoli Shao as well. He's also sitting on 2,000 gold, so he could pick up another Need to See Large Rod the next time he goes back to base if he wants it.
And who wouldn't?
Who wouldn't? Ackerman is dead.
He actually might be able to do some good damage to Prowly here before he gets out, but he actually chooses try to run on that, giving the team a little bit of time to position in. LMQ has slowed down a bit. Usually they're taking the rest of the mile here. Oh my gosh. Well, they will be able
to. This freewheeling style they're playing. They're playing a little loose right now. Once they have such a big lead on the enemy team. And everyone's just kind of trying to make a big play on their own because they don't feel like they're in actual danger of losing this game. If you do that for too long, you actually do risk giving up the game back to the other team. I think after that death, that would probably be the moment where LMQ says, all right, guys, calm down. We got an unstoppable Nidalee. Let's just siege.
Reel it back in. Xiaowei Zhao only has 2,600 to spend. You probably want to let him go shop. He's been window shopping for the past 10 minutes.
Or Vasily's going to try and kill someone.
Possibly. Or two people. Definitely better on the aggression. Hopefully he doesn't come back to bite them. They're very far ahead, and they can make multiple mistakes right now. Let's see. Complexity has a long way to scale throughout this game. We're only at level 12 to 14, but Xiaowei Zhao is 16.
It's actually kind of a cute way of getting rid of the Nidalee traps is Bubba Dub is spawning plants on top of the traps because they're actually doing a lot of damage if you want to step on top of them because of how much AP he has. It's about 330 damage plus the armor and MR shred to make the spears more potent. The plant locks are pretty clever by Bubba Dub.
Keeping the team safe, gotta remember. Not many wards actually being purchased or on the map right now for Complexity.
They're trying a flank attack right now. I mean, it's a last-ditch effort. Let's see if they can catch LMQ in a dive. They would hope that LMQ dives, I believe, before Kez would go into this if they want to play this as smart as possible. But they're going to try and play off of LMQ's over-aggression. Here they go.
This is where it gets tough. They don't have much to get onto a turret. Command Shockwave taking two in. This is the fight they could have wanted here. Westrice taking a bit of damage before he can really apply any more. Robert actually way too far in front there, and it's the return now. LMQ has put them in that pocket of reassurance and said, all right, let's go back in.
It was a one for one, but it's the AD carry and a lot of the wave clear from Complexity. Plus, they're all too low to get back in on this one. The sustain from Nidalee is also going to help them res up and take that turret. But Complexity, that was a pretty good fight, all things considered.
Yeah, LMQ has really no way to get to that turret with the amount of poke they have. But winning the fight just outside the base, that'll do great. Great shots from Vasily as well to keep Kez in a dangerous position. Probably, even with a blue elixir on his side, is trying to output as much damage as he can, being so far behind here. Great game being played by LMQ. They methodically go back to their ways. It's going to be the inhibitor and probably Baron to bottom lane if they can get that.
Feels like they decided to calm down a little bit.
Yeah.
Get back to basics, push down the mid inhibitor with the Nidalee in tow. They have hugely fed Lulus and Nidalees. If they don't do something, though, Complexity would be able to buy some magic resistance. They're at that point in the game where they want someone, or at least everyone, to pick up a Negatron Cloak because they have some of their core damage items on people, but they just don't have the gold for it. If LMQ continued to play really loose, like the way they had been playing after they got their big lead, it would open that up. Oh. But I feel like if LMQ plays more controlled, they're going to be just fine.
4.1K.
It's a lot of gold in his pocket.
What is he doing? I want his interest rate. 53K to 42K. Finally, did he?
Zhonya's straight up.
Yeah, he just perched it. Yeah,
and another blue elixir. So he's sitting at 629 ability power right now. Fair bit.
Death Spear.
Yes.
See how many he can land throughout the rest of the game. Complexity's definitely had good hands on some of them. Grabbing them up whenever they're in the air. 7-2 in turrets means that LMQ only has a few more turrets to fight Complexity at, and that's where they want them. Anytime Xiaowei Zhao can continue throwing death in the face of Complexity, LMQ's happy about it. It looks like they're going to try and get that a little bit towards the top lane here. They can stop the wave quite short.
Yeah, pink one brush, sweep the other to make sure the approach is dangerous as possible for Complexity. No Name, though.
Uh-oh.
Gets completely caught out of position. What a great catch by Complexity. Once again, LMQ not staying together as they're doing their vision sweeping.
Usually that's more just kind of keeping him out. Complexity was on that one. Very strong here. Bubba Dub still trying to harass. Bubba Dub is a very aggressive support, and he plays that style.
Initiation.
Really,
they're trying to do a 4v5.
Team think twice. He's very close there. Westrice on the outside as well. They have a good pinch. This could work for them, but Vasily so powerful, pushing them out. Xiaowei Zhao, another spear, down to 25% HP for Kez. He cannot help too much in the fight as they're back onto the turret. Bubba Dub almost getting grabbed. Bobbed up, get hit with a spear though. The second one connects that Xiao Wei Xiao has thrown. Third one goes out just on the tail of Bubba Dub as he heads for base. And LMQ is just waiting for the minion wave.
One thing right now, Complexity is close enough to their base that when a spear lands, they can heal up. And it is delaying these pushes from LMQ because they're not able to push as five as long as Complexity keeps getting these these catches onto LMQ. Or as long as LMQ keeps giving them to them in some cases with Vasili opening up in some suicidal situations, the longer they can stall.
Simple heals coming out. Everybody's able to stay quite healthy. Oh, got him on that one. Threw it out because of the trigger he saw. It's going to be the Stranglethorn going down. A great pop-up. They take down Vasili. That's huge damage for them. But where's Xiao Wei Xiao on the back line? That's what Complexity's looking for. They know they can be quickly zeroed out.
Another catch, in a sense. At that point, Vasili almost got them, but Westrise came in for the clean. They're going to continue this pressure, though, because the minion wave has arrived. No AD carry in LMQ. The Complexity wants to fight.
Gets no name. The rappel is going to be quite easy for him to get out of this one. Moore getting a good hook onto Kez for the re-engage stop, and Westrise taking a spear. It's always the 1-2 punch for LMQ. They never... Oh! And the third one, the kicker in the rear onto Bubba Dub.
Finally hits the bullseye. Does enough damage to clean someone out. That probably means inhibitor number two.
That is going to mean a lot more map pressure, Jat. Quickly taking this. They go for the kill onto Prowly. 48 seconds on these timers. We got 22 on Bubba Dub. That's the main crowd control for the team fight right now. If he were to come up, they could have the minions to go onto these Nexus turrets.
Yeah, they might. They'll probably just go for inhibitor number three with all the deaths they have
That's
created.
True. It's close.
They're a little staying in the base. Just playing a little bit loose, I would say.
Had a respawn.
Got to go refresh his blue buff. Xiao Wei Xiao is enjoying this game, I would say.
Yeah, just a little bit. Definitely coming out very strong in his different styles of play throughout playing Kha'Zix, Orianna, bringing out the LeBlanc. Now the Nidalee, definitely showing a champion pool that has not yet been banned out.
Yeah, one of his best games for sure. Picks up a Haunting, guys. That's surprisingly a really good item in this situation. A lot of people don't like Haunting, guys, as a sixth item because they think that's not enough ability power. You could just buy a more expensive item. But the interesting thing about Penetration is it is an increase to the percentage of your damage. So since he's doing 670 AP and doing 1500 damage with the spear, being able to do an extra 10% on that damage is actually more valuable than buying another 80 ability power. So the Haunting Guys is actually a tremendous choice right here, especially against low MR targets like Robert X. Lee.
Yeah, hasn't had any chance to buy it. Also doesn't have Valkyrie. He flashes, but the slow is on, canceling that movement. It looks like kill coming in from Vasili in the 1v1.
Yeah, that's probably going to be the last straw for this defense.
Yep.
No AD carry with two waves of super minions and a monstrous Nidalee coming in.
Very methodical game here played by LMQ as they take down the second inhibitor. Complexity make a last stand here at the home base.
Two super minion waves about to arrive.
Oh, the flash. No name, but the flash from Westrise. He gets popped up, played around. They tried to actually go instantly onto Xiao Wei Xiao and get the kick out so he can't affect the fight, but they're all over it. They all know what to do. Moore's going to get a huge heal there from the summoner spell as well as the surge, the primal surge from Xiao Wei Xiao. And it's going to be a 33-minute game possibly. They're still going for kills.
Oh,
he wants a point. Bubba Dub taking down flashes, jumps onto the fountain for himself to get the safety. And it looks like huge plays, 13-04 for Xiao Wei Xiao in the day as they get a few more points tacked on, and LMQ takes down Complexity.
Very solid win by LMQ right there. They had so much control during the early part of that game and so much domination of the vision, especially on the bottom lane of the map. I honestly feel like they just started having a little bit of fun in that one. They knew the game was in hand, and they wanted to show off a little bit. 14-05 on Xiao Wei Xiao's Nidalee.
Yeah.
A tremendous performance as far as Nidalee's spear destruction. And Complexity unable to capitalize off their nice game yesterday as they ran into a powerhouse.
Really great game by LMQ. Pick and ban phase going very much their way, and the standard laning phase playing into their favor immensely. We saw that, like you said, probably wasn't really dying to Xiao Wei Xiao in middle, but when Xiao Wei Xiao came back from having fun in the side lanes, that was big trouble for Prowly.
He was killing everybody. I think that's pretty safe to say. 14 kills. I believe Shifter had 15 kills in week one.
Right.
Also against Complexity.
We also saw the matchup Robert X Lee and Bubba Dub, a squishy matchup that LMQ loved that they got. Vasily on Twitch and the Thresh combo from Moore. They were also able to punish that bottom lane by themselves. And we did see a bit of the Vasily aggression come out today.
Yeah, a little bit of the over-aggression. He tried his chances with the first under the turret kill on Robert X Lee.
Right.
And then he just kept trying. But honestly, when they have that type of lead,